We're going to hear from the choir. Following that, we will come and hear the word of the Lord today. Praise God. Bless us, choir.
Yeah.
Lord God, we thank you that you indeed are the righteous Son of God, the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. Now, dear Lord, please give your servant preaching power this day. God, we need a word from you this day. And we thank you in the wonderful name of the Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
God bless your hearts today.
Amen.
Thank you. I just wanted to hear that number this before the word. Thank you. Thank you. God bless. The Lord is to be praised. And he is wonderful. He is wonderful. Thank you, Reverend Blanche Bouchard, DJ High, Reverend Johnson, to the celebration choir, deacons, officers, Lottie Dottie, and everybody. God bless you. Now, I told y'all, I woke up ready to preach this morning. But what's new, I always wake up ready to preach. But Psalm 122. Lord have mercy. You can rest on your feet when you have it. Witness in here.
Yeah.
I was glad when Nafis, they said unto me, let us go. Yeah, to the house of the Lord. That's all I want this morning. Before you take your seat, just look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Put your preaching voice on. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh.
I'm glad.
I'm glad
I came to church.
I came to church.
You may be
seated.
I'm glad, Lorraine, I came to church.
Come on now.
Elder Simeon, growing up under my parents' supervision, we were made to go to church every Sunday. There was no debate. There was no conversation. Brother Terrence, there was no negotiation.
No.
You were going to church. Do I have any witnesses that were raised like I was raised?
Come on now. Right about it.
Sister Darlene, even during times when I faked sickness.
I know that's right. Go on anyway.
I would pretend, Delilah, that I had some type of illness.
Well,
somebody to pray for you.
And my mother, who I believe was the best Dr. Quinn medicine woman, would prescribe for me Binky.
Yeah,
y'all don't know what Binky is, but Binky is Binky the belt. So when I pretended, Deacon Ron, that I was sick, Mama would bring BB in the house or in my room. And I don't know what happened, but immediately I was healed. By his stripes. I could not see, Reba, the value and the relevance of the church at the age that I was at. To the contrary, Sister Cheryl, there has come a realization that this world is a wicked place. That Lamar, time is filled with swift transitions. And there has come a point now in my life where I just can't wait to get in the house of the Lord on Sunday morning. Let me see if I can get some help on my left side. Is there anybody in here that can testify that you've been through enough hell this week? That ain't my side. Anybody on my right side that can testify you've been through too much from last Sunday up until this Sunday? Can I get some help up in here? And listen, that's why I got to come to the house of the Lord. Because if it wasn't for the church, I'd have cussed some folk out. I'd have gotten discouraged. I would have given up alone. Am I in the right church in here? Is there anybody in here on this Sunday morning, January 29, 2017? Anybody can testify, I'm so glad I made it to the church of the living God. The devil tried to keep me home. The devil tried to discourage me. People have gotten in my way. I've cried this week. I was in the hospital this week. I was discouraged this week. My heart was overwhelmed this week. But sure enough, when my foot struck Zion, my burdens were lifted. Can I get some help up in here? And is there anybody in here that can testify that since you come up in the church, the joy of the Lord is your strength? Can I get a help in here? And since I've been up in the church, I can declare that the Lord is my light. I wish I had help right through here. And my salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? In the time of trouble, he will hide me. Can I get help in here? Is there anybody in here that can testify? I'm glad to be in the house of the Lord just one more time. Come on, clap the hands and tell God thank you. I'm glad, and let me pause parenthetically here and say this to you. That's why don't you ever let anything or anybody keep you from the church of the living God. Can I get help in here? Okay? You know, I've discovered that we've got fickle and shifty and trifling folk because, you know, people, can I get some witnesses in here? We live in a day and age where people will find themselves, they get mad at the church, and then because nobody sung their song, nobody put them in position, ain't nobody paying them attention, and then they'll walk out the church and won't come. Can I get y'all notice in the church? Come, folk come in, and then what I discovered, folk come in church with attitudes, ready to cuss folk out, and they even disrespect the church, the sanctuary, and cuss in church. I know it happens. But brothers and sisters, I need some folk that have enough respect for the church that can say, I'm just glad to be in God's house. I'm glad to be here. I'm not going to let no hypocrite. I'm not going to let no foolish folk. I'm not going to let unspiritual folk keep me from the church of the living God. God's been too good to me. Shame on anybody who will let anybody keep you from church. Don't nobody keep you from work. Can I get a witness in here? Come on, fake folk. There have been fake folk as long as we've been living. But when you were going up to the club, didn't no fake person keep you from the club. It's amazing, Tasha. It's amazing to me that we do church like we never, you know, we treat the church differently than we treat the world. If we went to a party, listen, if folk got on our nerves, we didn't stop partying. We just went to another place, another section where the party was. Can I get a witness in here? But if folk get on our nerves in church, we're ready to leave and transfer churches. But I need some folk that can testify that the devil is a liar. Can I get a witness in here? I've been planted in the church of the I ain't going nowhere. The devil gonna get out of here before I go anywhere. But I have a question I need to wrestle with today, Sister Humphrey. And this is the question I need to wrestle with today. What is it about the church that disturbs your spirit that if you miss it, you feel so unsatisfied? Because for some of us, we I know there's some folk that can say, Pastor, I'm gonna stay home and watch televangelists, watch folk on television. But let me tell you something, that ain't the same. Can I get a witness in here? I want to be somewhere where the Lord is. I need to be where the Spirit of the Lord is. But Tamika, what is it?
Come on, Pastor, come on.
About the church, yes, that keeps me coming Sunday after Sunday. Yes. The pastor gonna keep saying the same old, same old. He died, he was buried, but early Sunday morning, he got up with all power. Choir gonna sing, they gonna take up some money and all this type of stuff, but what is it?
Come on, Pastor, come on.
What is it about the church of the living God that draws you to the sanctified hollow walls of the church? Listen, there were days I said, I'm not coming to church, and then I reminded myself, you're the pastor, so you gotta be here. But what is it?
Come on, Pastor, come on. What is it? Hallelujah.
What is it? About the church.
Yes.
That draws you to these walls Sunday after Sunday.
All right, now.
Come on now.
Let's, for a few moments, walk through Psalm 122. Give me a good 15 Baptist minutes and I'm on my way out of here. Can the church shout hallelujah? Kia, this psalm is called the Psalm of Ascent. Somebody shout ascent. Meaning this psalm was sang on the way to the temple. For one of the Jewish festivals. It was written during the time, most scholars believe, during the post-exilic period. Somebody shout post-exilic period. The exilic period was a time when the children of Judah were placed in Babylonian captivity for 70 years because of disobedience to God. They were unjust, and they were some religious hypocrites.
Yes, yes. Uh-huh.
And God said, I'm not going to kill you, but I'm going to chastise you. Oh, I feel like preaching right through there. And can I just pause and put a pin right through here? That whomever the Lord loves, he chases. Can the church shout hallelujah? In other words, God won't kill you, but God will put a whooping on you.
Hallelujah. All right now. Come on.
During this exile, they were separated from Jerusalem. Separated from the temple. Can you imagine not being able to come to church? Can you envisage in your mind a time when you can't come and worship God? And that's why, church, let me say this. Whenever the church of the living God, whenever the doors are open, that's a time when you need to be up in church. Can the church shout hallelujah? That's a time when you need to be in the presence of God. I don't think anybody needs to miss church. That was a quarter in the meter. Take it for what it is. But now, the psalmist begins. He talks about the beauty and the splendor of Jerusalem. But Jerusalem is nothing without the temple. Which is to say, the church is needed in a time like this. That Philadelphia can't be nothing. Our community, our city, our state, our nation cannot be anything unless we have the influence of the church. Can I get a witness in here? And let me say this. It's time for the church to stop being cowards. It is time for us to stop hiding behind the doors. It is time for us to be the center of the community. Stop coming to church Sunday after Sunday and not doing anything. Because the community, don't you hear Jesus said, we are a light to the world, a lamp that's set upon the hill that cannot be hidden. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify. And so the psalmist pictures a pilgrimage to the temple. This pilgrimage is filled with rough moments. And he starts off by saying, I was glad when, watch this, they said to me, I'm about to get in trouble right through here. I was glad when they said unto me. Y'all miss me. Let me say it again. I was glad when they said unto me. Y'all still miss me. I was glad when they said, you know what that says? That brother, that sister didn't come to church by themselves. You see, listen, if you have experienced the joy of salvation, then somebody ought to know. You ought to be telling somebody about the good news of Jesus. I've said this before and I'll say it again. Many people expect the pastor or the preacher to grow the church. But that's not biblical. Sheep beget sheep. Can I get a witness in here? And so my responsibility is to equip you and empower you. Your responsibility is to go out and compel people to come to Jesus. Let them know that there is a reality in serving a true and really risen Savior. Don't you come to church all by yourself. He says, our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. Then he talks about the security of Jerusalem. He says, Jerusalem is built like a firm city where the tribes go up. You do know that Jerusalem was the place that God had decided to establish his name.
Oh, yeah.
And so the tribes were supposed to go up and to give thanks to the name of the Lord. But again, the city could be nothing unless the temple was present. And one of the results of the temple being in the city was that the throne of David, there was supposed to be justice and peace that flowed from the throne of David. Can the church shout hallelujah? That is to say that when the church is doing what it's supposed to do, then government will do what it's supposed to do. Then he begins to celebrate the beauty of Jerusalem. He said, pray for the peace or the well-being of Jerusalem, that it may prosper and those who love it may prosper. To those who are family and relatives, peace. And then he says in the last verse, that because of the house of the Lord, I will seek her good. Let me return verse 1. And let me hone in now and talk about why the church is important. What, again, makes the church in a time like this, where our world is in chaos? What is it, Ebony, that makes the church what it's supposed to be? Why am I glad that I came to church? Can I give you two things and I'm out of here? First of all, the coming to church clarifies and intensifies our hope that things will get better. Let me just make that make sense. That means that the church, I come to church because the church reminds me that although there's chaos in the world, I expect that things will get better. We are living in some challenging days. Hear me, Church of the Living God. We are living in some days where there's disappointing experiences. There are things that are going on in this world that will diminish our hope and give reason for us to say, where is God? We have a dictator in office. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? Y'all should have known I was gonna say something about that. That can sign executive orders that ban Syrian refugees from coming into our nation. They're trying to flee war-torn countries, and they're coming to a place to seek refuge and a better life. And this racist, narcissistic bigot has the unmitigated gall and audacity to make an unchristian and unconstitutional ban.
Talk to it, preacher. Talk to it.
And then you got some racist so-called white Christians. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? Because there are folk that are around here that's supposed to claim the name of Jesus, but they're going to back that nonsense. I'm going to push the envelope a little further. Because, again, we're living in some challenging times, right? This week, they had a march where the vice president spoke at a rally for women who they were defending the rights of the unborn. They can fight for the unborn, but who's going to fight for the poor? How you going to fight for the unborn, but can't fight for poor folk? Can't fight for affordable education? I wish I had a witness in here. Not only so, but he can spend or wants to tax, raise to I believe 20% tax on imports from Mexico to build a wall, but Flint, Michigan still has bad water. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? And if that ain't nerve enough, this joker comes to Philadelphia and makes a bold yet inaccurate statement that Philadelphia has the worst crime rate. Who are you to come to this city? You don't even live here. And if we truth be told, crime is everywhere. These, and not only this, but Reverend Blanche, in addition to the hell that's going on in our world today, can I remind you that all of us got our own personal hells? Am I right, church, here? Some of us are battling issues in our home, battling issues on our job. Some of us are just wrestling with decisions, and some of us are wrestling with our children. Some of us are just at our wits' end, not knowing where to go. And you're saying, I have had enough. But I woke up this morning to remind somebody that despite what's going on around you, God is still in control. God can do what no other power can do. And Sister Patricia Hyden, let me say this. I'm not going to wait till I die for things to get better. Come on, I know we'll understand it better by and by. And I know I'm going to walk the pearly streets of gold. But right now, I believe that God's going to give me strength to walk these streets. Sometimes what goes on around you will cause you to become blinded to what God is saying. Sometimes you will lose hope. Sometimes you will think that this is the end of the world. But let me remind somebody, I've read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. And here's what I discovered, JoJo, that even though the enemy is acting up, at the end, God wins. Can I get a witness in here? I don't care what's going on around you. At the end, God will get the glory. God will get the honor. Catch the church up. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Bless your name.
Lord have mercy.
Wake up, church. Uh-huh. Don't you allow things in the world or in your life to diminish your hope.
Yes. Hallelujah.
I have seen God work.
Yes.
I have seen God work miracles. And I said it to Reverend Blanche in the office that, yes, this is a time of chaos.
Yes.
Thank
you.
But this is a time when the church is being challenged to believe God ever the more. Is there anybody in here that believe God still works miracles? Anybody believe God is still healing the sick, raising the dead? Anybody believe it? Anybody believe that God can work in your home, work in your money, work in your, if you believe it, shout hallelujah.
Yes, he does.
And this hope,
helps
me to keep my vision clear.
Come on, Pastor.
It keeps me believing God. Because let me tell y'all something. God has been trying to teach this church this month, and I don't know if anybody caught it, but God has been trying to teach this church that we have his ear, that if we need it, he can do it. God has been healing. God has been, thank you, Jesus. He's been making ways, and if you believe it, God can do it. You walk like a king's kid. Stop walking like you poor. Can I get a witness in here? Stop walking and stop talking that negative, I ain't got this. Let me tell you something. My father is rich in houses and land. God will supply. Yes.
Amen.
Can the church out here? Never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed. Church, before this month is out, you better raise your level of expectation. Listen, you better get with God's program. Do you hear what I'm saying?
All right now. Never seen it. Hallelujah.
But one more thing and I'm out of here. I can see the runway. I'm going to land shortly. But one more thing and I'm out of here. Coming to church helps us to discern our calling in this world and our life. The theme of today's Mission Sunday is recognizing your calling.
Amen.
And each of us are called to do something.
Amen.
God is calling the church to engage this world to demonstrate the love of God.
Amen. Amen.
God is not calling the church to be discriminatory.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying? Let me see if I can make that make sense.
Go ahead, Pastor.
Because what we're living in, we're living in a nation where white Christians are trying furiously, and they're trying to make this a Christian nation. It has never been one to begin with. I'm going to say it like I feel it today. Because if anybody can go to your homeland and bring you here and make you enslave and then use the Bible to justify it, you ain't no Christian. If, somebody shout if, you can try to ban immigrants, let's just be straight up, all of us except Native Americans are immigrants. Am I in the right church here? Yeah, you an immigrant. And also, can I tell you, we serve an immigrant, Jesus. Can I get a witness in here? Can the church shout hallelujah? Because for a period in his early history, he fled from Nazareth or Bethlehem to go to Egypt. That's immigration. And you gonna try? You trying to ban immigrants? That is the most ungodly, unchristian thing. And I thank God that we got churches and Christians who are bold enough to go to airports and even protest. Y'all may get mad at protesting, but let me tell you something. It was because of the protest that's been going on.
That's right.
That the ACLU went to court, and there was an argument, and because of the argument, and they argued that what the president was doing was unconstitutional. And because of that, they placed a halt on what the president was trying to do. What am I trying to say? Get off your blessed assurance. And let your voice be heard. Don't you tolerate discrimination from a, listen, Lord, I'm a, because here's the ignorance of it. He was going to ban Muslims, but allow Christians in. How you gonna do that? Can I get a witness in here? You have no rights.
All right now.
And church, the only way that our voices are gonna be heard is if we get out in the street and defend those who cannot defend themselves. And the church, I'm almost through, church. I'm almost through. But the church reminds us that we cannot sit back idly and let injustice, we can't let our children grow up in a mean and hateful world.
Not again.
And I need some witnesses in here that can testify that the devil is a liar. I need some folk that'll stand with me and say the devil is a liar. Not in this country, not in this community. I'm glad. Can I get a witness in here? I said I'm glad. I done talked about all the bad stuff. Can I give y'all some good news? I said, can I give you some good news? If I can give you the good news, go and say, go on, Pastor. Brothers and sisters, we live in a mean world. We live in a hateful world. But is there anybody in the room that can testify that I'm so glad I came to church? Because when I came to church, I found out that Jesus could do anything but fail. Can you look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm so glad that I came to church. I'm so glad that I came. strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When it came, when I came to church, I discovered that now I take him that is able to keep me from falling. He's able. I'm glad I came to the church because I found victory in Jesus. I'm glad. I said I'm glad. I said I'm glad. Take a shot. I'm glad. I'm glad I came to the church because the church told me that no matter what you're going through, you can overcome, because Jesus, he died, he died, he died. Come on, y'all, and say he died, he died. Testify about that. I'm glad I came. Thank you, Jesus Christ.
Yes.
I'm glad. I'm glad.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
And I came to church.
Yes.
Because the church reminded me.
Yes.
That I am somebody in Jesus.
Uh-huh.
And it lifted me, singing glory. Jesus. Listen. Listen, you don't have to come to Jesus perfect. But if you come to Jesus just as you are, I serve a God that will work in your life and do what no other power can do. If you're here and you're not saved, let's stand together. If you're here and you're not saved, I invite you to come and be a part of the family of God. If you're here, you can come. Singing glory. God bless. Hallelujah. God bless. God bless. Come on, clap your hands, church. Oh, Jesus. I'm so glad, Jesus. I'm singing glory. Hallelujah. Listen, the second call is for anyone here that's not a part of a church. Listen, this church is open to you and anyone that desires to come. You can become a part of this family. You don't have to, we're not a perfect church, but I serve a perfect God that is at work in the church. So if you're here and you would like to become a part of this church, you come by letter, candidate of baptism, or upon Christian experience, no matter how you come, just come on. So glad, Jesus, I'm singing glory, hallelujah. Is there one? Come on. Oh, Satan, if you're here, you want to become part of the church, come on. Jesus, one on my left or my right, are you here? Jesus, are you here? Oh, Satan, turn me down. Jesus, singing glory, hallelujah. One more time, one more time. I'm so, so glad, Jesus. You know that I'm so glad, Jesus. Mm-hmm. I'm so glad. Thank you, Jesus. Singing glory. Get somebody by the hand. Oh. Praise the Lord. Get somebody by the hand as we pray together and ask the Lord's blessings. God is able.